Ciao ragazzi, siete mai stati in Valtellina? Have you ever been in Valtellina? If yes, please let me know your thought about that experience and your comments. It's gonna be very great for me. Thank you. Ciao ragazzi, il mio nome è Domenico e questo è il mio canale. My name is Domenico, this is my channel and this is my journey into the wine world, but more than that is a journey into the vision, the dream of the people that are behind a glass of wine. Today we're talking about this producer, Marcel Zanolari. Marcel Zanolari is a very unique producer in Valtellina, on the very east side of Valtellina, very close to Tirano, so very close to the way to go to Switzerland on the east side of Valtellina. Marcel Zanolari, why is unique? He's unique because, first of all, is a winery that long time ago married the vision of biodynamic production. And in Valtellina, believe me, being biodynamic is not really common and not really easy. Not easy because the weather, because the environment, because the landscape. Valtellina is a mountain place, a very different type of weather during the year, very cold in the winter with the snow, very hot and can be humid in the summer. There is a fresh breeze, Lake Como, and thunderstorm or whatever is very steep, so it's not an easy place to make wine in biodynamic way. Marcel decided to marry this vision, and I have to say that he's a truly, really biodynamic person. He believes in biodynamic, he believes in natural touch with the nature. That's why also he uses a lot of animals in the vineyards. He uses goat, he uses horses. And this also allowed him to see step by step, year by year, development of his soil always in a better way. So he realized that his vineyards now, the land is also more strong to the disease. The vineyards, the grape are very much more resistant than before to the disease. They don't need too much water. They are also capable to grow even in a very dry season. And also you realize that you can make wine completely different than other producers. Also using sun resistant grape called Piwi. So he used this type of grape in his wine, resistant to the disease. And also use a very different wine, type of grape comparing to other producers. He has Gewürztraminer, he has Pinot Noir, he vinified Pinot Noir in white, for example. He uses Pinot Bianco. Actually, many of them are also crossing border grape between Switzerland and Valtellina. Also, he discovered different type of vinification process. Normally, he tend to do longer maceration, but this is depending on the vintage, of course, depending on the health of the grape. Because working in biodynamic is also, you know, there is the other side of the coin. So, he's very natural, he's great, but of the vintage, you can have also good production or bad production or low production instead of full production. Does micro vinification for every single parcel. He has a lot of small tank where he put different parcels that where he following separately every single parcel of his 10 hectare property. Choosing different type of contenitori, different tank. For example, also using amphora. And this wine, for example, is a sforzato, but is a sforzato le amphore, in amphora. He made a sforzato like everybody does, but also he made a sforzato in amphora. And that's, this also for other type of wines. It's somebody that is really worth it to know, to go to visit. So if you are there, please go and visit him. He's very happy to show to the people his vision of Valtellina wines, which is totally different than others. If you like the content, please subscribe to my channel. It's gonna help me a lot to develop this, you know, this channel. Leave your comments and let me know your thought. If you ever been in Valtellina, let me know in the comments and share with me your impression of this place. I love Valtellina, and as you can see here, you can see some other video suggested, because I made different video on Valtellina. It's an upcoming place with a new generation of producers like Di Rupi, like Sandro Fai, like Marcel Zanavari, and like a few others that are changing completely the vision of this valley, the vision for the wine in this valley. And I think the future for this area and for this producer is going to be really bright. So follow me in this trip, and always, like I say, salute, sempre salute. Ciao ragazzi.